is Janet TV on the radio, and you're listening to Bring It In with Coach D, where we catch up with athletes and coaches from around the world. On today's show, we're going to recap the top teams and players in women's basketball as we head into the NCAA Women's World Tournament, which begins March 22nd. Now, Heather, I was looking to watch basketball this week, and on TV, I was disappointed because all that was airing was men's sports. I mean, the women deserve the coverage as well as the men. And so we're going to update everybody on what's going on in the women's basketball. The lack of coverage is disappointing, to say the least. Do you agree?
Yeah. I mean, I watched the news today, and all it was updates on the, you know, UT men's basketball, baseball, you know, regardless of the fact that the, you know, softball team had played too, and the women's basketball team had played too. It would be as if it's not actually occurring. I mean, you would think that they'd rather cover F1 than cover local women's sports playing. It's better than it was, but it's still kind of frustrating when you're just like, oh, well, I guess to find out about the counterpart of the UT program or whatever program it is, I've got to go online and find it instead of hear about it on my newscast.
Well, and that's why Janet TV is here. So let's start with basketball. The top five leading teams are Connecticut, who is 33-0. Notre Dame, 32-0. Louisville is 30-3. South Carolina is 27-5. And Stanford is 29-3. Most of those aren't surprising to most fans, but the top players for Connecticut are also in the running for the 2014 Women's Naismith Trophy. Senior center Stephanie Dolphin, senior guard Bria Hartley, and sophomore Brianna Stewart. The four finalists will be announced March 21st. What an honor, and good luck to these ladies.
Yeah, I mean, that's, I think you just named the final four for the women's. I mean, you can't watch any women's basketball games and understand, oh my gosh, they just went their entire season undefeated. I mean, not just one, but two teams. So I think Brianna Stewart was one of the top freshmen last season. You know, it'll be interesting to see who takes the top spot from Baylor now that Brittany Griner's not there. You know, it kind of opens the field up to the undefeateds.
Well, I think you kind of went into a weaker division this year, the American Athletic Conference, which may seem smooth sailing right now, but tougher for them when they reach the women's tournament. And they play teams like Notre Dame. Do you think this is in the back of UConn's mind as the NCAA tournament gets closer?
Well, I tell you, the bad time to have your first loss, for sure. So you talk and you hear about interviews from the coach and how he's like, no, we're not pressuring, we're just taking one game at a time. We don't feel the pressure. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I mean, you're undefeated. You have something hanging on it. It's not just like, we got to win the game. It's, we got to have the perfect season. I mean, that's a big distraction, really. You start thinking, oh my gosh, we can't lose, instead of let's win. You know, so changing in that mindset is crucial, especially when the game's on the line. So if you're playing up to lose, chances are you're gonna. It'll be interesting to see what happens when they actually meet some competition that doesn't roll over and has just as good athletes on their side.
I couldn't agree more. The top scorers in the league as of March 16th are Jerrica Coley from Florida International. She's averaging 29.8 points per game, which is impressive by itself, but even more knowing her team, Florida International, isn't ranked in the top 25.
Well, especially when you think most women's basketball games have, 60 on average, 60 to 70 points a game. If she's scoring 30, I mean, come on. That's ridiculous. She's a one-person team.
Well, closely behind her is Odyssey Sims from Baylor, who's averaging 28.4 points a game. I was curious to see who would step up after Brittany Griner, as you said, had left Baylor. And Odyssey Sims has been the dominating leader for the Bears team. Heather, how does it having dominant players benefit the program and the team when it comes to support?
Oh, I mean, you know, you see it from bigger programs when they have a turnaround player. A&M had it, and Johnny Manziel. You know, Brittany Griner was Johnny Manziel for women's basketball. So when you get somebody like that, I mean, you can just recruit around them, especially knowing, hey, she's going to be here for 4 years. So do you want to win a national championship? Come to my team. It's been smooth sailing for recruiting. I mean, that's crucial. You're going to have a huge surge, you know, 3, 4, 5 years after you have that dominant player like Brittany Griner leave. So expect Baylor to be right where they were, you know. So
I wouldn't be surprised if they make it into the top four, if not, you know, into the championship game.
Well, as we learned from last year from Louisville, it doesn't matter your record when you get into the NCAA tournament. All that matters is how you play during the tournament. The first round begins March 22nd, and so far 16 teams have punched their ticket to the NCAA tournament. This includes the first appearance in program history for North Dakota University. They will be led by Big Sky Conference Player of the Year. This team proved that you can't count teams out in sports, and they were picked 8th in preseason polls, and I'm sure this ignited their fire to prove the polls wrong. Heather, I know a lot of people like an underdog story, and we will be rooting for North Dakota as they make history in the NCAA tournament.
For sure. That'll be awesome. I mean, that's exactly why you play this tournament. That's why you put teams that are from Nowhereville, North Dakota, against, you know, the Baylors, the Yukons, and see what happens. I mean, it's a roll of the dice sometimes. I mean, at any given moment, any team can lose, which we've both experienced in sports, and, you know, that's why we watch it in the first place, because it's just exciting. You never know. So this tournament is unlike any other in that, you know, 64 teams play in a just rapid-fire pace till the end, and it's very exciting to see such drama, you know, unfold right before our eyes with everybody, you know, these 18 to 22-year-olds putting everything out on the line and giving it their all. It's going to be really fun to watch this year.
Well, no matter the outcome of the tournament for North Dakota, haven't they already won?
Yeah, I mean, for the program, for sure, it's always good to have those milestones. So, you know, next year if it happens, it becomes an expectation, you know, so you build off of this, just like we were talking about Brittany Griner. You build your program off of successes, and each year those successes become norms. And, you know, just like it's expected to win Big 12 title. It's expected to be in the championship game or the Final Four. So when you get the level of expectation, people rise to meet it. You know, for North Dakota, I mean, this is something that next year they'll have that same expectation. Since they did it last year, why can't they do it this year? And, you know, it's all about recruiting. So if you say, hey, you can stay in North Dakota and you can still play in the NCAA tournament with everybody else on TV, come join our program. It'll build for them, and it's really good to see that, and it needs to happen more, and more programs need to come up and create the powerhouse program so that we can see these battles instead of lopsided victories.
Well, the 64 teams going into the NCAA tournament will be announced this week. Two teams are already punching their ticket, UConn and Notre Dame. As we said, they entered the tournament undefeated, which is only the second time in NCAA Division I women's basketball history. This also gives them the opportunity to be the 8th team all-time to go undefeated on the season. So do you think they're going to do it?
Ooh, I'd say no. But, I mean, it's happened before, so don't ask me. I'm horrible at guessing, so If it comes down to it, if I say yes, it's not going to happen. If I say no, it's going to happen. So I'm going to go ahead and abstain from answering that question and just enjoy the game.
Well, so many stories waiting to unfold for the women's NCAA basketball tournament. So stay with us as we will be updating you throughout it. This is Coach T, and you're listening to Janet TV on the radio.